गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, चैप्टर टू दैट इज द अर्थ एंड द चेंजेस ऑन इट्स इज गोइंग ऑन। इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड विद यू दैट वेरियस एजेंट्स ऑफ ग्रेडेशन दैट आर रनिंग वाटर ग्लेशियर विंड एंड से वेव्स। टूडे वी विल डिस्कस विद यू व्हाट इज सॉइल एंड द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ सॉइल। लेट अस सी, सॉइल इज द लूज मटेरियल फॉर्म ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ द अर्थ। इट इज मेड ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक एंड इनऑर्गेनिक पार्टिकल्स। व्हाट इज ऑर्गेनिक पार्टिकल्स? द ऑर्गेनिक पार्टिकल्स आर डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम डेड रिमेन्स ऑफ प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स। After a very long period, these particles get decomposed and change into a dark colored material called humus. The humus present in the soil contributes to the fertility of the land. What is inorganic particles? The inorganic particles are derived from rocks. They include loose disintegrated particles of different sizes. The large size particles are called gravel, while the smaller ones are called sand, silt and clay. A mixture of these particles give rise to different types of soil as per their properties. These are called sandy soil, loamy soil and clay soil. Now we will discuss with you formation of soil. The action of the sun, water, ice, wind and plants break huge pieces of rocks to form soil. This process is known as weathering of rocks. Can you guess the process of weathering of rocks? It starts in the very beginning when the earth's crust was made up of thick layers of rocks. Thus, rocks were heated by the sun and cooled by the rain. Alternate heating and cooling results in the formation of cracks in the rocks. When it rains over cracked rocks, water enters the cracks. In winter, this water freezes in the form ice. Ice in the crevices of rocks expand and cause the rocks to break into the smaller pieces. Sometimes the roots of plants enter the crevices of rocks. The roots grow and require more space for themselves and so break up the rocks. The moving water of streams, waterfalls and rivers also break large rocks into smaller pieces. Thus, smaller pieces of rocks undergo various changes and finally form soil. Soil formation is a slow process and it takes thousands of years to form a layer of soil, a few centimeters in thickness. The soil itself not the same throughout. It also has a layers of structure you can see in this picture. The first layer of the soil is called top layer of the soil. It is very fertile and plants grow in it. Below the top soil is subsoil. It is hard with most pieces small rocks. Below it, weathered rock pigments where is little no plant or and animals live. The bottommost layer is a bedrock, which is the starting edge of the earth
millions of years ago. In short, the soil is the mixture of minerals and broken rocks. Take it, organism and the decaying organic matter. Again, I repeat, it starts developing in the layers one over the other. These layers are called horizon. You can see these layers are called horizon. From bottom to top, the lowest horizon is called bedrock. Then come the horizon of weathered rock, and it is followed by the subsoil and topsoil, and the topmost horizon is rich in humus. Now we will learn in brief today's topic. First is, what is soil? Soil is the loose materials found on the surface of the earth. It is the mixture of minerals and broken rocks, living organism and decayed organic matter. How you will reply? Soil is the loose materials found on the surface of the earth. It is the mixture of minerals and broken rocks, living organism and decayed organic matters. As you know, the top layer of the soil is rich in humus. So we will know what is humus. The dead and decaying organic matter is called humus. Humus is dark, soft and rich in nutrients. After that, we learned about transported soil. What is transported soil? Transported soil, the weathering process breaks the rocks into the small particles. These are then carried away by water, wind, etc. and later get deposited at a new place. Such soil is called transported soil. After that, we will discuss that what is residual soil. When the soils formed by the weathering of a parent rock and remains present on the same site, is called residual soil. After that, we will discuss with you again the formation of soil. How the formation of soil occurs? The soil is formed in millions of years. The soil formation is a very slow process and it takes thousands of years to form a soil. The weathering process breaks the rocks into the small particles like water, ice, wind, climate. A big piece of rocks breaks into the small particles. These small pieces of rocks undergo various changes and finally form soil. It started in developing in the layers one over the other. From bottom to top, it is called bedrock. Then comes the horizon of weathered rock, and it is followed by the subsoil and topsoil that is rich in humus. That's all for today. Thank you and have a nice day.